Freeway Ricky Ross is a street legend. He went from being a poor, illiterate, aspiring tennis star to one of the biggest drug dealers in Los Angeles history. After being part of an international drug ring and making up to $2 million a day, he's starting over from scratch and trying to build another empire, this time the legal way. 20 years of prison have turned this former kingpin into a fully literate activist who is trying to make a difference by keeping kids from following in his footsteps. Today, he sits down with RT to talk about his rise and fall and to discuss his connection to the CIA Contra controversy. Ricky Ross, thank you for joining us today. A lot of poor neighborhoods here in Los Angeles have suffered from gangs and drug abuse, and a lot of people blame you for that. Now, how do you think that you can help and rebuild these communities?
Well, I think I'm the perfect one for this job that needs to be done because, I mean, if you haven't lived this life, it's like an experiment. You know, my life has been an experiment. And had I not been through this experiment, then I wouldn't know what happened. You know, most people don't know what happened in South Central. They don't know how you get started selling drugs. They don't know how you get out of selling drugs. They don't know how you can go from being illiterate at 28 years old to being as literate as I am now. You know, basically, I do law work. You know, like I said, I'm filing my paperwork today in my lawsuit.
What do you think about the rapper Rick Ross taking on your persona?
He's never sold drugs. He's never been involved with any type of crime. You know, he was a college boy, played football, from what I understand, and he was a prison guard. You know, and you know, to be a prison guard, your record has to be spotless. You know, so he's definitely created a fraud, and you know, he's perpetrating a lie.
What role did the U.S. government play in bringing crack cocaine into L.A.'s poor black neighborhoods?
The government needed this money to fight this war over in Nicaragua against the Sandinistas. Russia had gave the Sandinistas $100 million to fight with. Congress had cut off all the money from the Contras. So now the Sandinistas had an advantage. Reagan and Bush had made the Contras their pet peeve. They felt that if Russia took over Nicaragua, they would be too close to America. They would be in our backyard. I believe that they felt it was more valuable to sacrifice a particular sector of America and a race of people in America in order to save the whole country. So they let these guys open up pipelines. Danilo Blandon, Norman Nessus, and the rest of the crew that worked with the Nicaraguan connection. Because I knew about 10 or 15 different Nicaraguans that was all inside of this, you know, Contra organization that was selling drugs. So by them allowing these guys, or basically turning a blind eye, because I don't think the government necessarily gave them the drugs or whatnot, but in a sense, they sanctioned it because they turned a blind eye. They knew that these guys were selling drugs, but they did absolutely nothing about it. I also believe that had they not let these guys sell drugs, it's possible that I would have never become a drug dealer.
What does that say about our government when they're looking the other way while a deadly substance is coming into our communities for the sake of fighting a communist regime in Central America?
Well, it says that our government will sacrifice its people to accomplish a goal. And this is not the first time that they've done that.
That's the real Rick Ross. Uncle Rick Ross. That's the baddest bitch they got in L.A. right now. That's the baddest one they got in L.A. And look, it's me and my folks.
Gassing out them rats. Bitch. We gassing out them rats. Gas chamber a sack. We gassing out them rats. We gassing out them rats. Them niggas ain't got stacks.
The real Rick Ross told me I'ma give Ice-T a run for his money. And you know, every time I meet somebody that's more famous than me, I be thinking about they remember me. So when you see famous people, ask them if they know me. They gonna tell you, yeah, I know, bruh. He be having hella pizza rock. I celebrated for SIBO. This is his favorite drink. He call it C-Rip. But we drunk this shit, and I had a good time in this hotel suite. And now I'm about to go do a photo shoot. And, yeah, me and baby girl, we enjoying ourselves. You feel me? And if you ain't got no happiness in your understanding, motherfucker, and you mad because I'm in VIP, and the real Freeway Ricky Ross come up to me and tell me, oh, nephew, you gonna give Ice-T a run for his money. So when I watch N.A., what's this, NYPD Blue, and I be seeing Ice-T on here, am I wrong for thinking my bitch gonna give COCO a run for her money, Ice-T? I seen AP9 had her, but I ain't trying to get your bitch. I got my own. Well, yes, sir. I do. I'm going to show you her walking out the room. She thick, too. That's a real ass. That ain't fake. Told you. Them is hips. Okay. You can't buy that on Craigslist. You got the room key, baby? Because we got to do this photo shoot. All right, y'all. We see y'all later. We got stuff to do.
Gassing out them rats. Bitch, bitch. We gassing out them rats. Gas chamber a sack. We gassing out them rats. We gassing out them rats. Them niggas ain't got stacks.